so great to see you guys, man. Yeah. You're looking good.
Thank you.
Look at that tie.
I know.
Dude, thanks again for stopping by.
Dude, of course, man. How could I not? Africa's a huge deal. How long are you guys gonna be gone?
Oh, 2 years, brother.
Huh. It's a long time.
Yes, but it'll go by in a snap. Plus, we're providing a sacred service to all those who need it. It's gonna be so fulfilling.
You guys are gonna have a great time.
We won't, but it's not about pleasure, and it's not a vacation. It's an opportunity to spread God's light.
Right. I just can't believe you guys are leaving. I mean, we're like best friends, man. We're family. You're gonna miss movie night.
Oh man, don't remind us.
Well, I got some gifts in my car. I'm gonna go get them really quick.
I'll come with you.
Oh, you don't have to.
No, I could use some fresh air.
Bart, we're outside. Okay. Yeah, let's go.
Chris, we'll be right back.
She comes at midnight.
What?
She comes at midnight.
Who?
The hot Mormon girl.
What are you talking about?
Why do you think me and Chris became Mormons, Michael?
I don't know. I thought you guys were in search of some sort of enlightenment. I don't judge.
It has nothing to do with enlightenment. It has everything to do with the hot Mormon girl. She uses her hotness to seduce dudes into joining the church. It's too late for us. You saw how far gone Chris is. You can still save yourself, though. Go home, turn off your lights, shut the blinds, and whatever you do, don't open the door, okay? Just because me and Chris are Mormons doesn't mean that you have to be. She comes at midnight.
My coworker is having a going away party. He's going on this big Mormon mission trip to China.
It's happening everywhere.
What's happening everywhere?
The hot Mormon girl.
Okay.
And she's coming.
Nice, dude. I didn't know you liked Mormon chicks.
It's not like that.
Why are you freaking out? I'm sure she's gonna like you.
I'm not freaked out, okay? And it's not about her liking me. She turns people Mormon with her hotness.
What do you mean?
Okay, you know how it's like really easy for us to say no to all those salespeople who come to the door, like the political advertisers and those little demons who sell us those cookies?
The Girl Scouts.
Yes. You know how it's really easy for us to say no to the Girl Scouts?
Yes.
Well, this girl makes it impossible to say no to. Because she's so hot, she comes at a time where all these dudes are lonely and depressed and easily manipulated, and then she turns them into little Mormons.
All right, that checks out.
That's her.
What do we do?
Stay calm. She'll go away.
They always do. But she saw me come in here. She knows we're here.
She'll go away, dude.
What if she's not even that hot?
Dude, she's gotta be hot. Every guy that I saw today had a name tag on.
You know, now that you say that, I did see a lot of guys with name tags on.
Yeah.
I was like, why is everyone wearing a name tag?
Not me.
Not you.
Not you.
Not me.
What are you doing?
Well, you said she's a hot Mormon girl, right?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna go out on a limb here and assume that she looks like most hot Mormon girls. Blonde. Nice eyes. All-American girl look going for her.
And?
I like my women how I like my steaks.
Japanese.
And fatty. Mm. She won't have an effect on me, dude.
Don't go near that door.
Relax.
I'm one. Don't go near that door! Jude! No!
Hi, would you like to learn more about Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior?
I think so. Would you like to come in?
Of course, I'd love to.
We're not interested.
Michael, what are you doing?
What is that?
Coffee and vodka.
Why would you do such a thing?
Well, the Mormon code states thou shalt abstain from alcohol, caffeine, tobacco, illegal drugs. You're 2 for 4, baby.
Wait! Leave the book.
Look like an angel, walk like an angel, talk like an angel, but I got wise. You're the devil in disguise, oh yes you are, devil in disguise.